Good morning, dear students. Today we are discuss the next topic is foreign exchange rate. What is foreign exchange rate, guys? We know that the rate of exchange on these two countries' currency exchange with each other. Generally, under this chapter, we are discuss how to exchange the one country's currency with other countries. And what the system of exchange rate measures in the economy. Clear, guys? See, foreign exchange rate. What is foreign exchange, guys? Two countries' currency exchange with each other is called foreign exchange. Clear? What is foreign exchange? Two countries' currency exchange with each other is called foreign exchange. Next one, foreign exchange rate. The rate at which the domestic currency can be exchanged for a foreign currencies as known as foreign exchange rate. What is foreign exchange rate? A rate of exchange on these the domestic currency exchange with foreign currencies. The rate is called foreign exchange rate. For example, like $1 exchange with rupees 50. Clear? See, once again we are discuss two different concepts, foreign exchange or foreign exchange rate. First of all, we are discuss what is foreign exchange. Two countries' currency exchange with each other is called foreign exchange. Foreign exchange rate, so it shows the rate at which the domestic currency can be exchanged for a foreign currency. That is called foreign exchange rate. Clear, beta? Exchange rate, we have two types of exchange rate. Fixed exchange rate or flexible exchange rate. Flexible exchange rate, as known as called par exchange rate. Clear? First of all, we have discussed flexible exchange rate. A rate of exchange determined with the help of demand of foreign currency and supply of foreign currency. Both demand and foreign currency and supply of foreign currency equal with each other, then flexible exchange rate is determined. Clear? So, determination of flexible exchange rate, where demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency. So, here is the demand of foreign exchange rate is determined. So, guys, first of all, we are discussing demand of foreign currency. So, we know that demand of foreign currency is a function of forex. If the forex rise, demand of foreign currency fall. The forex fall, demand of foreign currencies rise. So, both have a negative relation. So, it shows forex and demand of foreign currency negative relation. Supply of foreign currency or foreign exchange. The supply of foreign currency is a function of forex. When the forex rise, then the supply of foreign currencies rise. When forex fall, then supply of foreign currency also fall. So forex and supply of foreign currency both shows positive relation. Clear? We are discuss flexible exchange rate. A rate of exchange determined with the help of demand of foreign currency or supply of foreign currency. Both demand and demand of foreign currency and supply of foreign currency both equal with each other, then flexible exchange rate is determined. So determination of the flexible exchange rate, where demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency. So demand of foreign currency, it is a function of forex. When the forex rise, demand of foreign currency fall. Forex fall, demand of foreign currencies rise. So both demand of foreign currency and forex both shows negative relation.
supply of foreign currency. So supply of foreign currency also function of forex. If the forex rise, then supply of foreign currency rise. Forex fall, supply of foreign currency fall, both shows positive relation. Clear beta? Next one, we are discuss equilibrium exchange rate or par rate of exchange. So where is demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency, it shows equilibrium rate of exchange. So shows with the help of schedule and diagram, that's your forex fall, demand of foreign currency and forex both have a negative relation, so demand of foreign currency is rise. Due to fall the forex, the supply of foreign currency also fall, because forex and supply of foreign currency both shows positive relation. At 6 forex, the demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency, it shows equilibrium rate of exchange. Above 6 forex, it shows here is the supply of foreign currency is greater than the demand of foreign currency. Below 6 forex, it shows the demand of foreign currency is greater than supply of foreign currency. So above schedule shows at 6 forex, demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency, so it shows equilibrium exchange rate. Shows with the help of curve, the above curve shows OX pairs demand of foreign currency and supply of foreign currency, Y pairs forex, that's your demand of foreign currency. The slope is slope of curve is downward sloping, because forex and demand of foreign currency both have a negative relation, so slope of curve is downward sloping. As supply of foreign exchange, the curve slope is upward sloping, because forex and supply of foreign currency both have a positive relation. At R point, demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency, it shows par exchange rate or equilibrium exchange rate. At R point, the exchange rate is 6 and the demand and supply of foreign currency is 30. At 6 foreign exchange, it shows here is the supply is 50 and demand is 10, so supply is greater than demand. At 2 foreign exchange, it shows here is demand of foreign currency is 50 and supply of foreign currency is 10, so it shows here is the demand of foreign currency is greater than the supply of foreign currency. So above curve shows at R point, demand and supply of foreign currency both equal with each other, so R point shows equilibrium rate of exchange, that's your flexible exchange rate. Clear beta? See guys, when demand and supply of foreign currencies change and what is the impact on foreign exchange and how is affect the appreciate or depreciation of the domestic currency. So guys, first of all, we are discuss depreciation of domestic currency. What is depreciation of domestic currency? Guys, we know that the value of domestic currency is fall, is called depreciation of domestic currency. Clear? Depreciation of domestic currency, the value of domestic currency is fall, is called depreciation of domestic currency. That means we have the requirement of more domestic currency for the purchase of the foreign currencies. For example, like $1 exchange with 60 rupees, but after depreciation the $1 exchange with 80 rupees. So here is the Indian currency or domestic currency, rupees is depreciate and dollar is appreciate. If the domestic currency is depreciate, then its impact goes, exports will be rise and imports will be fall. At the moment, the domestic currency demand of foreign currency is greater than the supply of foreign currency, so forex rise and the domestic currency is depreciate. The above curve shows OX pairs demand and supply of foreign currency. Y pairs 4x. That's your DD demand of foreign currency or SS supply of foreign currency. R is equilibrium 4x OP1 and demand and supply x1. When demand of foreign currencies rise, the new equilibrium shift from point R to G and point G shows at new equilibrium at Z point the forex will be rise F2 and demand and supply also rise X2. So it shows when demand of foreign currency rise, that means the demand of foreign currency is greater than supply of foreign currency, forex rise, so rupees is depreciate. Clear? If supply of foreign currencies fall, that's your supply of foreign currency fall, so the demand of foreign currency is greater than supply of foreign currency and rupees also depreciate. Shows with the help of curve. Above curve shows OX pairs demand of foreign currency and supply of foreign currency. Y pairs 4X. DD demand of foreign currency. SS supply of foreign currency. So at R point equilibrium, because there is demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency. When the supply of foreign currencies fall, then supply curve shift leftward and new S2 supply of foreign currency intersect demand of foreign currency at Z point. G is new equilibrium point. At G point the forex will be rise F2 and the quantity demand and supply of foreign currency fall X2. So here is, if the supply of foreign currency is fall, then demand of foreign currency is greater than the supply of foreign currency and rupees depreciate and RBI correct its with the help of sales of dollar in the market. Clear? When the demand of foreign currencies fall and supply of foreign currencies rise, then also Indian currencies appreciate. So first of all, we have discussed the appreciation of Indian currency. Appreciation of currency. The value of domestic currency rise, then it's called appreciation. Of domestic currency. Clear? Appreciation of currency. The value of domestic currencies rise, then it is called appreciation of domestic currency. So if the demand of foreign currencies fall, then the supply of foreign currency greater than demand of foreign currency, so domestic currencies appreciate. Appreciate means the $1 purchase 60 rupees and after appreciation $1 purchase from 40 rupees. So after appreciation we have the requirement of less foreign currencies for the purchase of dollar. So guys, at the moment when Indian currencies appreciate, its impact goes on exports will be fall and import will be rise because import is cheaper. RBI corrects from purchase of foreign currencies because the supply of foreign currency is more, so RBI purchases it and the demand of foreign currency will be equal to supply of foreign currency and the foreign exchange rate is balanced. Shows with the help of curve. The above curve shows OX pairs demand of foreign currency and supply of foreign currency. Y pairs 4X. That's your DD demand curve, SS supply curve, R equilibrium because there is demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency. At R point, forex will be rise P1, forex is P1 and the demand supply is X1. If the demand of foreign currencies fall, so new demand curve intersect as a supply curve at G point. It shows the forex fall from OP1 to OP2 and quantity demand and supply also fall from X1 to X2. Clear? So if forex demand of foreign currency fall, then forex fall. So it shows here is the supply of foreign currency greater than the demand of foreign currency. So rupees is appreciated. Clear? Next one, supply of foreign currencies rise, then the supply of foreign currencies greater than the demand of foreign currency, so rupees appreciate and dollar is depreciate. The above curve shows OX pairs demand of foreign currency and supply of foreign currency and Y pairs forex, that's a DD demand of foreign currency SS supply foreign currency are equilibrium because R point demand of foreign currency equal to supply of foreign currency. So at R point the forex is F1 and the demand and supply is X1. If the supply of foreign currency rise from $2, so new supply curve intersect DD demand curve at E point. E is the new equilibrium point. Is the new equilibrium point because at E point the forex will be fall from F1 to F2 and the quantity will rise from X1 to X2. So above diagram shows here is demand of foreign currency is less than the supply of foreign currency. So the Indian currency is appreciate and the foreign currency is depreciate because the supply of foreign currency greater than the demand of foreign currency. So that's your change in demand of foreign currency like rise or fall, supply change in foreign currency supply like increase and decrease, and how is the affect the values of domestic currency appreciate or depreciate. Clear beta? Next one, we are discuss the difference between appreciation of domestic currency or depreciation of domestic currency. So first of all, appreciation of domestic currency, the value of domestic currencies rise in the economy is called appreciation of domestic currency. Value of domestic currencies fall in the economy is called depreciation of domestic currency. So in appreciation exchange rate fall, in depreciation exchange rate is rise. In appreciation we have the requirement of less rupees, in depreciation we have the requirement of more rupees. In appreciation the supply of foreign currencies rise and demand of foreign currencies fall. In depreciation supply of foreign currency fall and demand of foreign currencies rise. The example of appreciation, $1 is equal to 60 rupees and $1 is equal to 40 rupees. So here is rupees is appreciate. And the example of depreciation, $1 is equal to 60 rupees and after depreciation $1 is equal to 80 rupees. So that's your example of depreciation of domestic currency. Clear beta? That's your foreign exchange. So you have the some questions, prepare on your fair copies. The first one is, what is appreciation? What is depreciation? What is appreciation of domestic currency? What is depreciation of domestic currency? When Indian currency is appreciate, what is the impact on export and import? When Indian currency is appreciate, what is the impact on export and import? When Indian currency is depreciate, what is the effect on export and imports? And how is correct RBI? Clear beta? Briefly explain the flexible exchange rate with the help of schedule and curve. What is foreign exchange? What is foreign exchange rate? So all the questions you will prepare on your fair copies. If you have any doubt, any topic, then you can contact me. My contact number is 9910214225. You can call me anytime and you can take any all the doubts anytime. Thank you very much.